I know what I'll do. This is a song we usually do electric, but I'm gonna do it acoustic tonight. My father was in the 101st Airborne, Band of Brothers. You know, they, World War II, they were in Bastogne, surrounded by German infantry and tanks and stuff, and those guys stayed there until the Big Red One eventually got them. And my father never talked about this, you know, and I always wanted to do a song for him, but sometimes you just can't do it because the subject is too close. Now, it's different when you're talking about wives or girlfriends. Oh, that's a whole other story. Oh, boy. But I couldn't write one about my father, you know? And he was like my hero. Never talked about the war, never talked about any of that stuff. Worked for the post office his whole life. He was a postmaster, really great guy. Everybody loved Al Misato, you know? And he was a really handsome man. So, I was living in Nashville, which is where I lived for a long time. And I got a call from my friend Tony Colton, and he said, look, we have to write a song for Clapton, and we have to write it by Friday. Jamie Oldacre is going to bring it over on Friday for the record he's doing, which I don't know which record it was, but we put it together. So he sent me, threw these words across the table in a writing room. And I read them. I was playing this little riff, and he was very English. Tony wrote I'm No Angel with Dangerous Dan Toler. And I said, what are these words about? He said, well, he said, they're about my father. My father was an English infantryman in World War II, and he landed on the beaches on D-Day, and he said, and my father died on that beach. And he said, and Eric and I grew up together, and he knows the whole story. He knew he knew the whole thing that was happening. So we did it. Eric got it. He demoed it. But I put it out on my record because it was too much for his. I mean, I understood that. But my father heard the demo that went to Clapton. And he looked at me one day, and he had the most beautiful blue eyes, this man. And he said, thank you for writing that song for us. And I said, Dad, it's for English soldiers. Now, he said, you wrote a song for all of us. And I really appreciate that. So I've done this song like thousands of times. And every time I go, Dad, I'm doing it again. I hope it's okay. I miss him. But I've had a lot of people over the years say, thank you for writing a song like that. And I always say, sometimes I get political on stage, but not usually. And I try not to do that. But I always say, this is not political. This has nothing to do with anything. This has to do with soldiers. It has to do with people that are protecting us every day and get their asses kicked most of the time when they come back, you know what I mean? Come back to divorces and bankruptcies and just stuff that's not right. So we always have to take care of those guys. We have to make sure that they're all okay. And this is for you, Dad. This is for everyone that's a veteran out there, including my buddy Steve. Disco Pride of the Cockney Rebels.
Then they ran like cowards in the red light of fear.
and the turn that made us stand. Souls drive men into the blades of swords, into the arms of angels, into the valley of the shadow of death they sail. The pride of the cognizant, into the pages of history. Down in a sea running red, Arnold Tyler was to carry them back home. To dance in the songs of sweet victory on the conquered streets of Rome. The showman down on Omaha Beach, picking the flies on the sand. Then they ran like cowards till they ran out of fear, and the turn that made us stand. Souls like men into the blades of sword, and into the arms of angels, into the valley of the shadow of death they sail. The pride of the conquering
to the flames of swords and